Let us now study about the energy and wavelength of emitted radiation. Thus, we are going to discuss about a hydrogenic atom. We know that from an initial energy level N1, an electron transits to or excited to N2 energy level. It absorbs some energy. One electron makes a transition from higher level to lower level. We know that it emits electromagnetic radiation in form of a photon, of which the energy is given as En2 minus En1. This we have studied in Bohr's third postulate. And here this energy is emitted in form of a photon. So, if the radiation wavelength is lambda, it can also be written as hc by lambda or h nu if nu is the frequency of this photon. Now, we can easily calculate the amount of energy for a given transition by substituting the values of En2 and En1. Like here delta E we can write energy of an electron in a hydrogenic atom in N2 energy level can be written as minus 13.6 Z square over N2 square minus of minus 13.6 Z square over N1 square. So, on simplifying we are getting delta E is equals to 13.6 Z square 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. This is the expression we can directly use to calculate the energy of emitted photon, and as I have substituted the energy in 13.6 electron volt units, so the result will be in electron volts. And here 13.6 Z square we can write as ionization energy of a hydrogenic atom. We can also write for a hydrogenic atom, 13.6 Z square is its ionization energy, which is also termed as ionization potential, or this ionization potential is also denoted as IP. So, here this energy delta E we can write as IP of the hydrogenic atom multiplied by 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square in electron volt or whichever unit you wish, you can calculate the total energy. And if you wish to calculate the wavelength of emitted radiation, the same can be equated to hc by lambda, and the wavelength lambda here we are getting is hc over delta E. If we are having the value of delta E in electron volt, then in this situation, hc and the conversion factor of this electron volt is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 that we can use. So, this will be 6.63 into 10 to the power minus 34, the value of Planck's constant, multiplied by 3 into 10 to the power 8. Divided by, if we have this energy delta E in electron volt, we can multiply it with the conversion factor 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. Now, if we calculate the values of these constants and we convert the units into angstrom, the value of wavelength lambda here we are getting is 12431 divided by delta E. Directly, we are getting the wavelength of emitted radiation in angstrom units if we know the value of delta E. We can directly convert it into angstrom units if we know the value of delta E in electron volt. The same can also be used as a reverse conversion if we wish to calculate the energy if a wavelength is given. This can be written as 12431 divided by lambda. Here if we know the wavelength in angstroms, then directly we'll get the value of energy of that radiation photon in electron volts.